I seem to have spawned in a cage. I thought I was invited here, so why am I stuck in a cage? I don't get it. Hello?
Who is that?
Nope. I was invited here, but I'm stuck in this cage.
Well, I didn't invite anybody here. Why would I invite anybody here? This is a single-player server.
I'm not even worried about the invitation. I'm worried about why I'm in a big cage. Do you just...
In case anybody tries to break into my server.
Yeah, break in? I didn't break in. I was let here.
You
let me in.
If I invited you, I would have given you a password.
Password? I don't have a password. You didn't give me a password.
I would have given you a password if I invited you.
I don't have a password.
What's the password?
I don't know.
Alright, you can just rot in that cage then.
Wait, what? You just gonna leave me here?
I have a password. I would have given you a password. If I invited you on the server. Do you have a password? Do you know what the password is?
Is it, password?
That is the password, yes.
Okay. That was pretty easy. Well, that was a beautiful welcoming into the server. So we've had a bit of luck. Jay has had a lot of stuff prepared, and he decided to share. So we had some stuff given to us to help us accelerate our beginnings at our own base. So first of all, we were given some maps and some gear. The gear is the armor you see on me currently. It was some pretty good armor, so I don't think it needs anything else. Maybe thorns. Not much else. And a single silk touch pickaxe. And it was a sharpness sword, but I've had a lot of zombies and skeletons, so I decided it was a good idea to change this, as well as upgrade it, so I combined another sword from the diamonds I got, and I made this, as well as a fortune pickaxe. All the iron you see here, most of it will come from spawn. The iron farm in there is ridiculously efficient, so I don't have to really worry about making an iron farm anytime soon, because it supplies way more iron than I think I'll ever need. So we have just so much iron. It's not even funny. It's a joke at this point. There's just so much iron. So, we've spent a little bit of time exploring our base, getting to know the area, and checking out what we can do here. Now, this plains is massive. Massive. It's at least 5 maps big. Some of it's split off into some forested area, but I'm going to consider that a plains anyway. And then this river kind of separates that into the spruce, which is what you see right behind me. So, we have this beautiful map. There's a sunken ship. There is some treasure right here. And then we have a village right here, which is not that far from our base. So we're going to be able to make us a villager breeder very, very soon. And we also have some area up here I'd like to see what we could do with. And there's so much room here for these little islands right here. I'm kind of curious of what I'm going to do with those, but I don't want to do anything yet. I kind of want to sit and think on it for a bit, because these are some big areas. These could have... this one's a lot smaller, but this one's really, really big. And it could be a port or a bay, or it could be a whole bunch of different things. So I really want to sit and think about that. There's a few smaller islands out here, and I'm thinking about some turtle farms. I think I saw some turtles out here. We've also got this rift out here, which is... I'm not sure if we'll do anything with it. We might just cover it up. It looks pretty nasty. It looks like someone tore the map. We were originally going to put this map under here, but it's just a bit too much to crane my head upwards for that. So we'll probably expand this map at some point and move it to the center and get it repositioned. But for right now, this gives a very good idea of what we've got here. So we did some exploration, and we do have some bamboo. So this is really, really nice to have for both fuel and scaffolding. We will be needing a lot of this later. And I did some digging. I sent JCraft about 10 shulker boxes of gravel and sand. So he has a lot of materials, and I kept some of these for myself. We'll probably end up using these at a later date. I don't have a blast chamber yet, so we'll hold on to these for now for some building. But we do have to do a lot of basic stuff, and I'm going to probably montage the beginning and the end of them. I'm not able to time-lapse a lot of this because I really want to get through this and get a very short but very quick video out that shows you guys kind of everything that's happened around here. I do want to forewarn that a lot of the farms and stuff are going to just be very temporary. They're not going to be permanent, but we're going to leave some of the stuff we have here alone. I'm not going to do any landscaping yet. I'm just going to put stuff where I need it for right now, and then move it once I start getting more of an idea of what I want to do with my base, because I have no idea right now. There's a lot of terrain around here and a lot of potential for some underground stuff as well as for some above ground stuff, and I really do want to see what I can do here. So I'm not going to rush anything. And that might make it a little bit harder for me to get a video out, but I'm going to do the best I can because I want what I build to look good. We've got our first villager here, and we're going to get him along this pathway. This probably isn't going to be really easy, but we have to get rid of a lot of stuff in the way. And we have to at least have two white area to work with, so I built this little channel that goes all the way over there. And at the end of it, I've got some leaf blocks and bricks to allow them to not take any suffocation damage while I try to get them to a minecart to get them to the base. This should be relatively easy besides the rowing, which just takes an absurd amount of time. But, yeah, there it is. Right there. It should be real easy to get him in there. I hope he doesn't take any suffocation damage because I'd appreciate that a lot. I don't like hurting these guys as I get them to my base, so I went sheared a tree, and it should be relatively easy. Yeah, there we go. Alright. So now we just break the boat, and we just gotta get him to wander to this composter. This composter is the only one he can use. Get him to go over there. His AI should take over in just a minute once he figures out where he's at. But let's see if we can push him in the minecart anyway. Up there. There he goes. And he's on his way. Now all we gotta do is just push him out of the way. Alright, so the next project that's gonna be made is a bone mill farm. And it's just gonna be very simple. I'm just gonna use a small bit of materials, a cactus farm. I'm not expecting this rates to be really well. I just need a small supply of bone meal to help with the crops for this spot. So we're going to have a chest right here, and this is where our bone meal is going to go, with a composter right on top of it. And right on top of that, we're just going to have another hopper. And from here, we're just going to create, I think a 11 by 11 platform, I think, is what this is going to be. So we just need to go 4 blocks away from the hopper. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we just connect all this up and make a wall around this. And we should be able to very easily pour some water in this. And it shouldn't go outside of this once this is done. So now with the water in place and everything, all we have to do is build up our wall quite a bit. Cover this up. Place in the fences. And then build a second layer. Which we're going to do right now. So we finished up the cactus farm for right now, and I think I'm going to try and figure out what other micro farms I need to build, because I think that we've got enough, but this cactus farm is not going to produce a lot of bone meal, so we'll have to wait this one out and see what happens. I'm going to AFK this overnight and see how it does. Alright, so we AFK'd over here overnight, and we only managed to get 49 bone meal from this farm, so it's not that great. There's a couple pieces left in here, so I decided it would be better to expand these crop farms on both sides, so that when I want to breed these villagers, all I'm going to do is just throw them a bunch of food. It also removed the inside bricks, because it seems a little bit better that they might have a better chance of spawning a baby villager on top of a solid ground. I'm not sure if farmland influences that at all, but this design probably won't stick around for long, because I was here for over 8 hours, and there's no villagers in here. So that's a very bad design on my part. But at least we have the villagers to do something else with if this doesn't pick up. So we'll try the crop idea later and see if we can get some villagers out of it that way. The next few projects we have are going to be some micro farms. I have some quartz, some redstone, and some wood. And I made a very simple cobblestone generator to start getting us some pistons. We're going to be using some kelp, bamboo, and what is it? Kelp, bamboo, and sugarcane. So we've got some kelp, bamboo, and sugarcane, and we need to be able to make some farms for these. So we'll do the kelp last, because the sugarcane and the bamboo will be very, very similar in style. So we're going to craft up some pistons and grab some iron. So the design should be fairly easy to do. So we're just going to have 8 pistons facing into the farm. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And then this is where we would place our crop of choice. So this would be our sugarcane. And then over here would be our corn. And all I have to do is replace this over here. And add these pistons again. Probably not. So we're just going to face them back here. Like this. Should be able to put dust. If this still works, so we're going to test this out for just a second to make sure we're going to be able to get everything out of this. We'll test this design with bamboo first, just to make sure it's going to grow properly. A stack of bamboo will be a good testing product. We plant some bamboo and it grows through tall, pops, breaks. Very nice. Perfect. Alright, looks good. I'm not really worried about these being too efficient. I just want them to operate and work. I'm not worried about the efficiency because we will be scaling these farms up very, probably very soon, because we'll use a lot of this for other materials and other farms. I know I'm going to use the bamboo for crafting sticks. That might seem a little strange, but it'd be really good to have a stick farm. Oh wow, that's already breaking pieces. Wow. Look how fast this is. Bamboo does grow really quickly. There, and I can catch that. One thing we need now is some torches. And that's it. There we go. A very inefficient bamboo farm. Let's make sure this entire side works too, so grows. Yes. Alright. Very nice. Alright, so we have the sugarcane farm and the bamboo farm all done. The sugarcane, I still need 6 pieces to complete it. So we're missing just a few pieces over there, as you can see right here. The bamboo farm is... it's fast. Just in the time it took me to make that, I've already made 12 pieces, which I know that's not a lot, but that's still... it's a lot more than I expected of a tiny farm like this, so we might have to scale this up even more at some point, because that's just ridiculously fast. I'm really happy with how that turned out. We're going to build the kelp farm, but we have to do it a little bit differently. Obviously, kelp isn't underwater... technically, it's an underwater crop, and in order for us to be able to use it efficiently, we have to submerge the entire farm. We'll still be using this design here, but we have to be able to submerge the entire farm. So I think we're going to build the entire thing first, and then have a smelter in front of it that we can toggle on and off when there's enough fuel, and that way we can actually have smelted kelp come right out of this thing, rather than having to wait for it to do anything else with it. So I think we managed to get that. We're going to use the bamboo to fuel the smoker down here for the kelp. And once we get enough kelp, we'll probably end up making a few blocks and making it self-sufficient. However, I don't want to put the kelp blocks in there right now because this is just a very small-scale farm and I don't want to waste the blocks inefficiently. So we'll look into that later and get a bigger kelp farm at some point. The only problem we're having is that some of the kelp actually stop too tall. So we'll have to keep an eye on this farm because it'll probably eventually stop operating at all. It's very likely. And the sugarcane farm, we finally got all the pieces in there, but it doesn't look like anything's growing too fast in here. This is a very small scale farm, so it's just meant to produce a little bit. However, the bamboo is just chewing out bamboo. It's ridiculously fast. So I like this farm a lot. This one's pretty efficient for what it is. Oh look, another piece already. But with that, I think that's it for this video. There's a lot I really want to do, but I don't want to make this video 2 hours long. So I want to ask you guys a couple questions, and I'm going to leave a poll right here in this video so you guys can answer this question and help me out on figuring out what I can and can't do. Jay has done a lot of work in this world, and I'm not sure how I feel about taking just about everything that he has built for granted. There's a lot of farms that are really overpowered that he spent a lot of time on, anywhere from weeks to a month. And I want to know what you guys think. Should I have access to these farms unrestrained, or should there be a limitation to what I can use? I really do think that some of these farms he's built, I want to build my own anyway. But a lot of them, like the gold farm and the wither skeleton farm and a few others, I just don't really want to rebuild something that we already have something of, especially when he's gone through the effort of putting in a world eater. But I don't want to seem greedy either. I really do think it is better that I've invested my own time into these projects to get my own rewards out of them. And a lot of the farms that he has are good for building materials, like the coal blocks and the bone blocks. They're great for building. So I want to know what you guys think. Should I have access to everything that he's built, or should I build my own? If you guys are indifferent about it and you want to explain yourselves a little bit better, you can leave a comment on this video, or you can join the Discord that is at the bottom of this video. And with that, I think that's it. See you guys next time.